Hey there, Pucks and friends, it's me, Arts. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It has been a while. Let's get into this. Sorry if you hear random noises in the background. I have a dog now. And yes, I moved. This is a new location. I will do a new studio tour soon. And my puppy's over there eating a stick. So you might hear noises. And his name is Junpei because best boy deserved better, JJK. But yeah. We have a big haul. Now, as you guys know, I am not a fan of AmiAmi. So, yeah, I'm not gonna mention them a lot. But we also have some stuff from Ride Stuff and Tokyo Otaku Mode, so I'm gonna open those first because I've been... Actually, you know what? Never mind. I'm gonna save the figures for last. So let's get into it. So here we have clear files, which I have two, I believe, that I got this month. These I always get because they're very useful for my job. I use these to protect my art prints as I travel or go to different conventions. So, oh my gosh, this is so cool. Okay, so there's this artist called Meme. No, that's a lie. Milgram is the artist, and they have different characters. So there's a song called Meme, which is with this guy, and he is the most prettiest guy ever. His name's Mikoto, and his birthday is October 6th, and this is Shido, October 24. I really love him, and then I searched him up on, you know, the website, and it turns out there's a bunch of different characters, and I just got all of them. He is my favorite. He has a special place in my heart. So those are these. Here we have acrylic stands. There's a whole bunch in here, so let's go through them. First we have the iconic from Modazushi, him. Here we have from Carnival, which is a manga, a small little keychain, which I just threw in there because why the heck not? Oh, we got Hinata Shoyo. This is one of those small acrylic stands that I knew I don't want to pay like a lot of money for, but since it's Hinata, he's my comfort character, I paid it either way. And last but not least, of course, we have again Mikoto, who sings the Meme song. Milgram. This is beautiful. I think I'm gonna have to put him like not on my shelf but like on my book, on my desk, because he is so pretty. So we're gonna move into the figures now. We're gonna go from smallest to large. So let's start off with Ride Stuff, which I finally got the Kita Nendroid, the Shinsuke Kita Nendroid from Haikyuu. Guys, how are we feeling about all of those Haikyuu Nendroid reruns? The Kenma gets rerun, then the Kuro, and I was like, you know what, if they're gonna give us Ken Kuro, they're gonna have to give us, I mean, Kuro Ken. If they're gonna give us Kuro Ken, they're gonna have to give us Boku Waka. You already know, they're gonna give us Bokuto and Akashi. When Bokuto dropped, I was like, that's it. And then they came out with the Oikawa school uniform edition. Guys, when I tell you, that has been on my holy grail for the longest time. You don't understand. Now I'm just waiting for the Kenma school uniform edition and I'll be happy. Or, and the Lev. I need the Lev to go with my Yaku-san. Anyways, here's Kita. I am most likely gonna have him with the... I want to give him like the little cape, the little school thing, but it's probably not going to be that one. It's most likely going to be the one where he's holding the little bag of food, because yes. So there's him. The Kita Nendroid for some reason was pretty difficult to put together. I've never really had this much struggle as I did with the Kita Nendroid. I was kind of having a hard time, but he is put together. I'm not going to be moving him because, as you know, I don't really change Nendroids too much, so he's gonna be staying like this for a good long time. And he is so cute. I love his hair. It's so cute. I put Kita with his little captain jersey and he's still holding the food bag. So he's kind of like, yeah, this takes up too much of my time. He is so cute. I think they really did a good job in formatting him into an Android version. Haikyuu always does that. The Haikyuu Androids always look great. So, job well done, like always. Good Smile always does their best when it comes to Haikyuu Androids. Very excited. I would like to see if they're gonna make Asuna. I mean, I know they did an Atsumu and Osamu, but his right-hand man would be Suna, wouldn't it? Interesting. I don't know. But he's super cute. I'm super excited to put him on the Haikyuu shelf. Then, moving on, moving right along, as you guys know, I made an anime figure pre-orders list, and this figure was supposed to come out in February, I think, March maybe. He's finally here, and I think I said he was $60, and I was incorrect. It was $30 because it's only a Bandai Spirits. But look, my guy, guys, if you know, Sanji's the love of my life, guys. Like, oh, now I need to like figure how to cut this without like taking forever. Sanji is the first anime character that I've like wholeheartedly simped over. Like, simped over. I didn't realize. I thought I simped over characters, and then Sanji came into my life, and I was like, oh no. This is a problem. Here is the box. Oh my god. He is so pretty. So this is before I realized how Bandai works. Not in the sense that they're a bad company. It's just, they're just like Band Presto kind of. Like, they're nice figures, but I don't know if I'm gonna be investing in Bandais or Band Prestos anymore. I think I'm just gonna go for pop-up parades and hire. Just because I don't want to have a hit or miss situation, so. But I'm still very excited about this. Here is the Bandai Spirits Sanji 100th anniversary. Super simple figure. It's just one piece of plastic. This is what I mean. They're very tiny. I don't even know if they're worth the $30 anymore, so I think this might be like the last Bandai Spirits I'm gonna be collecting. And they put like a label at the back of his outfit, like there's a label. I don't really like that, but it's still really cute. It's still Sanji and I love him, so he's gonna just go somewhere because I love him so much and he looks amazing. I had to have him in this Bandai Spirits just because I love his suit so much, his red suit. His face looks incredible. His face is very much like, ugh, here we go again. We have the scene, the iconic, when he's like fixing his tie, like that 2 second scene. We get it in a figure. Freak yeah. I mean, he has the gloves, the cigarette, the pants, like he looks so good. The base is ugly, but thankfully it's one of those peg bases, so he doesn't need a base to stand. He just needs to be balanced and he'll stay. Sanji's so pretty. I love him. I love him so much. I got my Hinata Shoyu wall scroll. I have been waiting for this one. As you guys know, I already have one. But this one's so pretty. It's so pretty. They're both so pretty, but this one is just like a tapestry looking, and I don't know where I'm gonna put this in my room, but I'm gonna figure it out. He is so cute. Okay, so now I know what this is. This is the acrylic stand that I believe goes in front of this little figure set. They're so cute. It's Wei Wuxiang and Lan in their little, like, in like a bunny version, chibi thing. These are basically the figures. And you put this in front of this, I'm pretty sure, to make it like a little diaphragm thing. So adorable. These were so hard to get my hands on because they kept saying out of stock. Like, immediately when they were in stock, they were already out of stock. And I was like, are you serious? So I had it in my wish list. And freaking finally, I was up one day and went online and they were available. So so excited because they're so cute. They're like, they release a bunch of like little versions like this, and all of them are adorable, but this one took the cake. Like, I loved this one. But there are the boys. They are precious. They are so small and cute. They're extremely easy to put together. It's really cool because they also have a clear base that you could put them on if you don't want the little mochi pumpkin bases. This one has a little stain on the blue, which is kind of a bummer because this one was my favorite one, but they're so cute. I could not even care. They're so freaking cute. The outfit details, they're so stunning. Their little feet, their little tails. They're so cute. And if you look under his hair, he's also holding like one of the little melon buns. Like, so detailed and cute. Guys, you see this shirt? Okay. I did a lot of JJK art recently because, do you guys remember in that video I made of the pre-orders list of 2022, I said that I was questioning getting the E-Stream figure of Gojo because I didn't know if I liked his face or not? Well, I pre-ordered the Yuta figure, and the Yuta figure has with Rika the red, like, E-Stream effect that they had going on. And Gojo was matching with the blue, and I was like, man, I should probably get that. But I didn't know, so I kind of, like, didn't pre-order it. And then, I left it in my wish list, and then I went to watch JJK Zero. I felt like extremely in love with Gojo again. I forgot how hot he is and how like sinisterly cool but like good guy he is. And then I read the manga again, and then I watched the anime with my friend, and now I'm doing JJK art and I'm obsessed with JJK and Yuta and Touge. And so eventually what happened was I pulled the trigger and it was in stock. It wasn't out of stock, and so I got it. And you know what? The Nendoroid for the JJK Zero Gojo is $80. And I was like, no. Those $80 can be put into this figure. And so, introducing my second 1/7 scale figure in my entire collection, we have the Gojo Satoru Shibuya Scramble figure from E-Stream. Oh, it's my first E-Stream figure. Because my other E-Stream figure is the, Yuta. Wow, my brain. Look, it's an exercise tag. That is so cute. Exorcise. We don't exercise, we exorcise. That's right. So cringy. I'm just gonna pull it, because if I've learned anything from anime, you'd never rip it in half. So, get this puppy open. Maybe I shouldn't say that now that I actually have a puppy. Is that even a quote? Isn't the quote like, let's get this pup? Is that even a quote? Am I being weird? Probably being weird. E-Stream and Mappa always puts in extra care for their, oh my god, their boxes. Wait, is Mappa E-Stream? No, Mappa is the anime studio. Mega House! That's the one I'm thinking. Mega House does really good protection for their figures. Just like E-Stream does. Holy what? Guys, you know I'm a sucker for like packaging and like the way an item looks when you get it. I do not regret this. I do not regret this. I have been waiting for this. Oh, shut up. Shut up. They have freaking... don't worry. This was pre-ordered instantly. So pretty. So pretty. I'm so sorry to my puppy who's trying to take a nap. He's massive. Gojo did not have to come this hard. Okay. I said that. Okay. I said that, yeah. Oh my gosh. Does he already come on the base? No way. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Oh my god, he is so heavy. He has a belly button. Oh my god, he is massive. Oh my gosh. Oh, he is beautiful. Oh my gosh. If you're debating on getting him, he's still in stock. Go get him now. Oh my god. The base, the face, the waist. Oh my gosh. Look how massive this thing is. It covers my head. It could be a helmet. Ow! Okay. Okay, that actually hurt because there's like a peg. So you put his foot on here. Dang, all this weight is supported on just one foot? That's crazy. Breathe. Breathe. Oh my gosh. Guys, he looks so freaking amazing. He looks so freaking amazing. He's gonna look so good next to Yuta. I was very skeptical about his teeth and his tongue, and oh my gosh, they did so well. Can I marry this figure? I think I'm gonna marry this figure. Oh, he is stunning. Okay, this is the end of the video. Follow me on social media. All the social medias are gonna be in the link. Like, guys, I can't even speak. I'm like so shook by this beautiful man right here. Okay, let me get myself together. Guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed me freaking out over this guy. I'm so glad I caved and bought him. Let me know if you want to see a studio tour, because I am basically done with setting it up and I think it looks great and I would love to show you around. Studio vlogs are coming back in full force now that I'm officially here. Check out my Etsy shop below, same with my Instagram and TikTok, which is where I post about my art. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye guys.